Hello everyone, today the Class 11 SOTS will give you some advice on how to try to avoid the contagiousness of the coronavirus that is spreading quite quickly all over the world.
Why you should follow the 2-meter rule between people? Well, because first of all, the introverts will feel safer. And second of all, coronavirus can only travel so far. So if you stay away 2 meters from people, you should not get it.
Don't touch your face. Almost everyone has some bad habits. For example, it could be touching your face. It is estimated that people touch their faces about 23 times per hour. And touching your eyes, nose, and mouth with dirty hands allows germs that cause infections caused by bacteria and viruses to enter the body. Just think before touching your face.
Why it is important to cover your mouth when you sneeze? First of all, stops the spread of germs. If you sneeze into your hands, you could transfer germs from place to place after touching something. You need to use a tissue to cover your mouth and nose every single time you sneeze to protect people around you. You can sneeze into your elbow if a tissue is not available, but never sneeze into your hands or open air, because remember, don't do what you don't want to get.
According to the World Health Organization, the most common symptoms of COVID-19 are fever, tiredness, and a dry cough. Some patients may also have a runny nose, sore throat, nasal contagion, and aches and pains or diarrhea. In most cases, people can recover without needing any special treatment. If you develop any of these symptoms, stay in touch with your doctor.
LSM has dedicated a section on our homepage for COVID-19, and you can trust all the information you will find there without a doubt, because it's the most trustworthy source there is. LSM is Latvian public media, where information comes from resourceful sources. LSM is also in English and Russian, so that anyone can read it.
Why is it important to visit friends and family with video chat or via phone, not in person? Social distancing is important not to spread the virus even further and to make sure that you and your family are not a threat to each other. But at the same time, you don't want friends and family members to not have the support of loved ones, so check in with them by phone or on video.
There's no need to stockpile on face masks, gloves, or any other medical supplies that are needed for medical workers. They don't protect a healthy person from catching the virus. Instead, you could take care of your hygiene, remember not to touch your face, nose, or mouth, and practice social distancing.
You should check in with your friends and family because most of us are isolated from the outside world and some of them might feel lonely. So keep in touch with them and then they might not suffer from the loneliness and also you won't too. Even small talk can cheer their day up.
Every day, people make posts for their followers. Just imagine, one of your followers is a 12-year-old girl who trusts and believes you. She sees something about coronavirus in your story and starts talking about your story with friends. And what happens if your information is false? So we should double and triple check the source of information about coronavirus before sharing it on social media. Just think about it.
Since the coronavirus is currently the most talked about topic, there is a lot of information going around. It is important for us to not just read the latest news about it, but to share it with others as well. Whether we do it by sharing it on social media or telling the people we know, especially if it has something to do with ways to stay safe. Sharing information keeps everyone updated, especially those who may not pay huge attention to this and who can be misinformed.
In conclusion, I think the most important thing everyone should remember is that all these measures were not made as a joke. There is scientific evidence behind every one of them, helping to stay healthy. And after all, especially in such troubling times as these, why should you take the risk? Do it for your family, for old people, but mainly for you yourself.